10 subscribers already, guys. 10 subscribers. Oh my god. Thank you guys so much. 10! 10! 10! Yeah. Cool. Thank you guys so much for 10 subscribers already. Like, this channel hasn't been, like, on YouTube for, like, a week. And it's 10 subscribers. Wow. I was shocked to even be able to have one, to be honest. but 10, that's amazing. Thank you guys. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Okay, so now we did not receive any questions due to the small number of subscribers. Hopefully that'll grow. Hopefully we will get questions very soon from people who want to ask questions. Yeah. So I am going to do my backup topic, which is, well, you saw it in the title. It is, I'm going to talk about questions that I've thought to myself growing up throughout the years. Also, what people have asked me growing up through the years with Asperger's, like, what that they're like, what, you know, what's the deal? So how I'm going to do this is I'm going to start from my childhood, work my way up till about now, recently. I'm going to try to keep it as, you know, as fast as I can, as quick as I can, keep the answers short and sweet. You know, I try to keep the time frame short with this video, obviously, because otherwise I will be I will be taking a huge amount of time with people. So please bear with me. I will try to keep this video really short. Now, so when I was a child, I thought tons of questions to myself. Obviously, I was a curious child. I was always interested in things, but when I discovered that I had Asperger's at 4.5, I didn't really think too much. Firstly, just because I wasn't really thinking of Asperger's or even what really it was. I just thought, oh, okay, I have this. I have this, this is great, you know. I got to about 6-7 years of age and I started thinking to myself, because a lot of the kids, like, looked at me like they knew there was something different with me. Even when I was 5 years old, they kind of knew there was something different about me. So the first question I thought to myself, I was like, well, why are they, you know, why are they viewing me in this manner? Why are they thinking that I'm different? Why? That was the first question. The answer to that, I didn't really get too much of an answer from them, because they were kids themselves and, you know, they were just more into what they wanted to be in. I didn't really get an answer. Yeah, but I did get an answer later on in my life, which basically I discovered that people just view others differently who are different, and that's how they process things. They're like, oh, you're different, you're not like who I normally deal with, so you're different. Yeah. That, I guess that's how their minds process. Maybe not everybody, but I did notice that with quite a decent amount of people throughout my years, even. So that was the first question I really asked myself. The other things were like school related, like teachers were like, why is she, you know, not focusing like the other kids, what's going on? And you got to remember, this was also in the 90s. This was the 90s. They had a big, huge to do with disabilities and everything else, being like, you know, put your kid on medication if they have this or that or this or that. I did have to go on Ritalin. I did have to go on that. That didn't really change me that much. And that was another question as well. I was like, why do I have to take this medication? I am not sick. I don't feel sick. I just thought as a kid, that was when I was like 10 years old, but I just thought as a kid, I was just like, I'm not sick. I don't need to take medication. I'm not sick. I'm not, I'm fine. But my mother didn't really know the answer, and she went by the doctor, and didn't really do anything for me anyway. It didn't really do much for me, and I stopped myself. I eventually went up to mom. I was just like, Mom, this isn't, working out. This isn't my thing. This isn't helping me at all. And so I just stopped. But that was another question later on, just near the end of like my elementary, primary school years. I was just like, what's up with that? Other than that, just throughout my elementary, primary schooling, I was just like, why are people treating me differently? Why am I having a harder time to make friends? I didn't really have friends when I was growing up. I was more interested in doing what I wanted to do, like, rather than being around other kids. I wasn't forced to make friends by my parents. They were good on that front. They were just more like, let her do what she wants to do rather than making her become really social and, and put her in a position where she feels uncomfortable in life. So they were great on that front. They always listened to me. They always listened to what I was interested in, and they always asked me, what are you doing at school? Especially my mother, she was like, what are you doing at school? How's it going? How's the teachers? Blah, blah. She didn't put me in an uncomfortable position of, oh, how was your day today? Because I was worried, because I didn't know if you were going to get picked on today or whatever, which I did get picked on a decent amount, but I didn't speak to my mother about it because I felt it was unnecessary because I dealt with it in my own manner. I dealt with it by really ignoring it and just continuing doing what I wanted to do. And my mother didn't really see any problem with that. So she didn't really continue questioning, about or worrying about, really. It's more like worrying about. She was just more into what I was doing, and that was great. And I was in the choir, I was doing sport, I was doing hockey, I was doing gymnastics throughout my elementary, primary years. I was and those are group sports, and I hear a lot of things from parents, saying, oh, my child doesn't get on with the other group of sport or anything. That's because they are, they can't work in groups, and that's fine. And I was told that, and I had it in my reports that I was more of an individual child than wanting to be in groups. But I kind of still got on in my own way. It's kind of hard to explain how, just in my mind, I just thought, just keep going, just ignore it, and just go on your own, and that's how I got through. And then I got to middle school. I got to like intermediate middle school. The making fun of and things like that kind of died down a little, but, I was brought up in like a small town where people know everybody, and kids who were in my elementary, primary school came all the way through my schooling with me. In the end, they just, When I got to the end of high school and they went on their own way, I went on my own way. We'd lost contact and everything else, and it all didn't really matter. And I thought to myself, I was like, see, that doesn't matter. I was right or wrong, and it really doesn't matter. When you if you get picked on, it doesn't matter. It will go away. It will go away, and it does make you stronger. It made me stronger. At the time, I was just like, oh my God, why? And then I was just like, nope, just keep going. Just keep going. It'll all be over soon. And it happened. And I can't answer that for everybody. Everybody's different. Everybody's got their own lives. So I'm just saying what happened to me. That was that. Oh my God, it's already 11 minutes, 7 seconds. Sorry. Then I got to middle school, and the questions I asked myself then, I was more like interested in high school, learning about the new experiences there and everything else, and being like, oh cool, I get to do new things. I get to like organize my life more and get ready for the real world and everything else. And I got a lot of what I call dog heads. I got a lot of people that were like looking at me being like, well, why are you thinking like that? It's like, don't you want to like hang out with your friends and like party and everything else? I'm like, no, not really. Not really my thing. I'm like, I want to like see the world and do things, and but everybody else looked at me at dog head with dog heads, and that's also because I live in a small town. And that's the other thing I thought to myself. I was just like, why does everybody look at me with dog heads? And now, looking at it now in the life that I've lived to now, going off to America, living in other parts of New Zealand, I'm just like, a lot more people look at you with dog heads. Even I can't answer for people who do not have Asperger's. I don't know if they experience that too. Maybe if you could answer that in the comment box below, maybe you could be like, well, it's happened to me, and then I'll, because I've never figured out a way to deal with that. I've never tried to figure out a way to try to. I wouldn't say change, because you can't really change a person, but to deal with it. To deal with it, I guess, is the word. I don't know how. I don't know how, but that's another thing I've always thought to myself. I'm like, why are people looking at me with dog heads? I didn't ask my family. I didn't want them to like to get the wrong idea or to be worried about me. As a parent, I would say, also just to be aware of your child, not cuddle them too much, but just be aware of the situation. Oh, look at that fly. I got through middle school thinking that. Just being like, why are they looking at me with dog heads? Why are kids looking at me? Teachers looking at me with dog heads now. Really, now I'm looking back at it, and I think to myself, jealousy. Like they were jealous of me somehow. Maybe that wasn't the case. I never asked them, because I felt like, oh, they were gonna make fun of me, or oh, they were gonna like trick me or manipulate me or something or other along those lines. So I never asked. Then I got to high school, and high school wasn't really, I didn't really question it, not towards the Asperger's autism part, because by then I kind of already knew what to do, how to deal with it. I didn't really have meltdowns. No, wait, I did, well, I did once, and that was like when I was about 14. My grandfather passed away, and I had a real hard time dealing with that. Because he was like my best friend in the world. He meant so much to me. And I lost him. I went through the grief process. And he taught me so much too. He taught me so much, and he taught me about people and everything else. And my mother and father didn't really teach me about people. They were more just like, oh, experience it on your own, learn it on your own. But he taught me more about people, and I have high respect for him on that front, and I'll never be able to say thank you to him, but I'm really appreciative that he did that for me. It means a lot. But yeah, when he passed on, I went through a grief process. I did have a meltdown because of it. I didn't know how to deal with loss. I mean, the only other person I lost was my nana, my grandmother, my nana. She passed away when I was 10, and I wasn't as bad, but when I lost my granddad, I was pretty choked up. I was pretty lost. I was confused. I was in a confused, autistic, Asperger's state. I didn't talk to anyone then. I had my head high in the clouds. But that wasn't really a question. That was more like just loss. And I really just thought to myself in general with questions of like, why did I lose my grandfather? This is awful. Why? Cry, cry, cry. But yeah, other than that, I kind of already knew to deal with Asperger's autism. I kind of knew how to deal with it. It was just more the thing, like, why are people like looking at me weird? Why are they treating me differently? Why can't I just be like everybody else? And they asked me, they were just like, they're like, why do you think like that? Why aren't you thinking like everybody else? And that's what they asked me, which I found ridiculous. I was just like, well, because I'm me. Because I'm me. But they didn't get an answer from me, and I didn't get an answer from them, and I wasn't too concerned about that. Then I left home when I was 18, and I went to college, and I went to radio broadcast, and that was even worse because I got even more dog heads because I wasn't really like a social person, but I wanted to be in radio to prove that I could be social. But they didn't view it like that, the other students. They viewed it more like, oh, this is gonna get me a career, this is gonna get me a job, this is gonna give me a life. But I viewed it more as like a self, figuring out kind of situation, which it worked well for me. I got my social standards more up there, and everything else. But they looked at me even more with dog heads because I wasn't living the life that they were, or like the other, like the other students were, because they were kind of like being like sheepish. Where I was doing it for my own self-being, and they didn't know what to do with that, and I wasn't worried about that. I was just like, whatever. I'm like, whatever. I don't know. I don't. That was the big thing as well. But it got worse. It got worse. And no matter what, it still doesn't go away. It still doesn't go away. Even today, I still have that with other things, like just meeting people, meetings and things like that. It's just, they look at me like, what are you thinking? Why are you thinking like that? What's going on? What? And it blows me away. It blows me away that people can treat people who they may well know are different. They may know that they have a learning disability, and sometimes I don't know. It's kind of rude, I guess, is what I'm trying to say. It's kind of rude. Like, I wouldn't treat anyone like that. I wouldn't treat anyone like that. But anyway, so yeah, that's really the questions, and again, just questions people ask me throughout the years, just like, what are you thinking? Why are you thinking like that? What's going on? How's your How's your, oh, the people that knew that I had Asperger's, like I went to psychologists when I was 4 and a half, and they would, and I went again when I was like 10 or something like that, and they asked me things like, oh, how's it going, how's your social life and everything else, like asking me things that, I was just like, well, nobody else treats me like that, and I felt kind of cautious. I felt kind of like, what are you trying to do? I'm like, I know you're trying to like be nice and things like that, but I'm just like, I'm not gonna give you, I'm not gonna give you the information of my life. I don't really know who you are, And I thought like that when I was a kid. I was a very cautious kid. Yeah, it's hard because with Asperger's or autism, you have a real hard time trusting people. Like you can, you feel at times you can trust everybody, but then the people you think that are trying to help you realize that, oh, really, they're not helping me in a way, even if they are. Or even, I even if they really are serious, you still have that hard time. And I, especially as you get older, and I'm not trying to say, be worried about your child. If you're like a child or a teenager, don't be worried, because everybody lives a different life. Certainly me, you might live a completely different life, but I'm just trying to give you little points that happened to me. Yeah. So it's already 23 minutes. I'm gonna wrap that up there. I know that there wasn't too many questions about the Asperger's part of me, like me asking questions to myself, or me asking, well, them asking me questions, people in my life, but I was lucky enough to live a life where Asperger's, or didn't really take over with questioning. It was more like it was more like Asperger's was trying to take over my lifestyle, like kind of thing, at least to me. I didn't. Now looking at it, I just like look at it, I'm like, well, I have to live a life, I have a purpose, and I know some people who have Asperger's, they feel like they don't have a purpose, and they ask themselves tons of questions. They're like, well, what's the point of with this with life? I don't want to live with this in my life, I want to end it. Sure you can. But you can find a purpose. You can find it. If you're a high Asperger's person who is successful, you will know you can find things you need to do, or you can find things that you can do. You've found things that you have done. And now you're like, well, I've already done the stuff that I like to do. Now what? Just keep going. Keep going through your mind with multitasks, because I know people with Asperger's or autism, they have multitasking brains. I've met tons of people with Asperger's or autism that multi-think, and keep going to the next thing, and the next thing, and the next thing. Just keep going. And you'll have a much better life thinking like that than just thinking, oh, I've done one or two things and now what? And don't sink into the depression state, because I've gone through that a couple of times, and that will probably be the next thing I'll speak about, is the depression part of Asperger's autism. I may talk about it eventually. We'll see. But anyway, I'm gonna wrap it up because we're already at 27 minutes and I'm just rambling on now. But 10 subscribers, guys, that is amazing. Thank you so much. I will. Oh, I've made some social media like Twitter and Google Plus. I've made some social sites there, so you can say hello to me, or you can, you can join them or whatever. And I'll leave them at the end here. But those are there. I've also got the email. Don't forget, you can email me, and I'm more than happy to answer your questions there. But guys, as always, thank you so much. Please, please keep happy. Please keep healthy. Live each day with a smile. You can do it. I know you can. I can do it. I can do it. We can all do it. Ask me questions, please ask me questions. If you have a question, please ask. And also subscribe to my channel, please, guys. I would love to make a community where we can talk to each other, and we can answer each questions. Even you guys can do it. Even you guys can reach out and help answer questions for people, because we all need questions answered. Yeah. Okay, guys, I'm gonna stop now. I'm gonna go, and I've got tons of stuff to do today. I've got to finish my art piece. I've got my store, MV store, going on. I need to finish opening that up. So on. It never stops. But yeah. Okay, guys. I'll see you in the next video. It'll probably be next week. Remember, I'm doing it once a week, so each Friday they get posted. Each Friday they get posted out on YouTube. Yeah. So just remember that. I'll see you guys next time. Bye, guys. Bye.